All right, internet fans, Evan Benton of Evdog from Air back for episode 2 of The Left Can't Meme. Let's go right to those spicy leftist memes. Alrighty, soap on top, someone I've never heard of. God does not want us wearing masks. If you have a mask on, it means you actually don't trust God. You don't have faith. And then below, with a disgusted look, Captain Picard, but you're the same people who need a rifle to pick up groceries. Whew. So this is failing to connect on several levels. First of all, they're choosing a quote by someone I don't think anyone's ever heard of, and using her to speak for the whole right. And then her statement doesn't make sense. You don't have faith if you wear a mask. I don't agree with that. I don't wear a mask. I think they're self-evidently stupid, but I think this is poor theology up here. And then who's saying this, right? So strawman versus strawman ad infinitum. Try harder. Jesus. The left loves to quote Jesus. I'll tell you one thing. If Jesus were alive today, he sure as hell wouldn't be a rich gun-toting long. So I think it's just the thing of rich and Republican being, you know, in the left's mind, they just go hand in hand. You can't possibly be a working class Republican, right? And that's why they fail. And just long words. All right. This is a old-fashioned political cartoon. I like it. The coronavirus vaccine? I'm not taking that unproven concoction. And yet he is sitting amidst several piles of unproven concoctions. Okay, so that's all these connections we're making. First of all, we got tinfoil hats. Seems superfluous. Conspiracy theories. Seems superfluous. You could just make... Well, what they do is they throw the bleach in here. They throw the bleach. I think Trump made a joke about something like that. I don't follow that kind of stuff too closely, but... these cartoons, they make a connection between livestock dewormer, right? They say hydroxychloroquine because no one, you know, because they haven't found a, you know, euphemism for that. But ivermectin they call livestock dewormer. Oh my goodness, it's used on animals. I've never heard of a drug being used on animals and humans. Get out of here, you conspiracy theorist. So, you know, but misnaming it and then... Just the package deal fallacy with the bleach, right? Associating proven treatments with bleach, effective treatments with bleach, and then just throwing in tinfoil hats and conspiracy theories, just for good measure.
Even though I was on ivermectin.
Danny was on ivermectin. And then just unironically, the same channel or page, it says this. Right, we've got new data showing that the COVID-19, the vaccine doesn't work on the COVID-19 infection. Right, just unironically, just out of nowhere, bam, the vaccines don't work, and it's just a disconnect. All right, changing gears here, back to Afghanistan. This one is a puzzler. All right, Joe Biden. It's August 13th, and I'm still here. So I tried to look up if there was anything significant about this August 13th date. There was one thing I found, which was Mike Lindell, the MyPillow guy. He made a statement that he was going to release something on August 12th that would cause Joe Biden to resign. But so I thought that might be it. But then in the comments on this meme, someone posted this. It's August 16th. I'm still here. So I don't think that's what it's about. I think it's just about Afghanistan and the fact that he's still president. I really think that this is a meme where they are bragging that a person has made it to the 8th month of their first term as president. I really think that's what this is about. Okay. Did you know a scorpion can hold its breath for up to 6 days? And Exelon can lie about climate change for 50 years? Oh, I didn't see that one coming. Clever. I'm going to go research Exxon, you guys. And then, I don't know. It's just cute when leftists try to be conspiracy theorists. The only thing they can talk about is the Koch brothers and oil companies, such as, oh no, not there yet. All right, this is just, this is sad to me because Arabs do not traditionally respect black people. If you're not clear on that, you know, ask some Arabs. They still have slavery in Arab-speaking countries. I really think that the Nation of Islam, for example, being a black African-American movement, is really some sort of a sick joke on black people by the elites. Kind of like the Boule, if you've heard of them, the black secret societies that use Greek letters. It's the same type of like formatting as white people use for college fraternities, but they're for adult black people. So they're keeping black people with the Boule. They're keeping them subservient to the whites in their secret society power structure. And I think it's just a joke. You know, I think it's like a cosmic joke. And it's just so tragic that leftists think that there's something like transgressive, you know, or empowering about using Arabic and connecting Arabic, you know, letters to black movements. It wasn't a black person that shared this, obviously. Okay, on the left, Trumpers. I've got a bomb and I will blow up the Capitol unless every Democrat resigns. And then the Taliban, wow, these Trumpers sure are radicalized. So you Trumpers, you're even shocking the Taliban with your behavior. And then it's just, you know, it's obviously it's a reference to the January 6th stuff, which seems like it was a false flag. But there wasn't any people with, I mean, there was those pipe bombs, but that was before anyone showed up, right? And, you know, and their demands had nothing to do with forcing every Democrat to resign, right? I'm having fun. I hope you are. This is where we keep capitalism's solutions to global warming. Yes. We're going to get into a little theme here. No amount of individual action will address the magnitude of the climate crisis. We need bold global policies, and lawmakers must hold big businesses accountable for their role in perpetuating the crisis. And there you have it. So the goal of the climate crisis is to propitiate global policies, right? We can't, no amount of individual action, just. But if every person on Earth just recycled, stopped using plastic straws and drove an electric car, 100 corporations would still produce 70% of total global emissions. And it's like, yeah, think about that a little harder. Do a little more research. You know, I think you're onto something there, Mac. I think you're onto something. Let's look at who these 100 corporations are. Seems knowable, seems doable, seems, you know, topical. But here we are. We've got somebody saying, it's not too late to stop the worst of climate change if we all accept reality and work together for the common good. And then the person down below in the audience says, we're effed. So this is what the left believes, okay? The left believes we are effed because we can't accept reality and work together for the common good. Alrighty? That's what they believe. So they're all on the right side. It's people who disagree with them. People who disagree with them fail to accept reality and also fail to work together for the common good. And that's the problem. That's the problem. Not these 100 corporations, but the people who disagree with the left are the problem. And so we need to get rid of them. You'll see that as a theme emerging in their memes. All right. Repeat after me. It's too late to do anything. Is the new climate denial, which we just said, even if every person on Earth just recycled, blah, 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 wouldn't do anything. New climate denial. And then she's saying, defeatism equals inaction. That's exactly what the oil companies, etc., want from the people. Like, huh? Conspiracy theory? So the oil companies are conspiring? The oil companies, this is the first I've heard, guys. This is the first I've heard. I got to look this up. There's got to be a YouTube video about this. Oil companies conspiring to cover up climate change. And then here's AOC. She owns them. She owns the oil companies who are saying, "We all scream for ice cream, but what's the science behind keeping this summer snack cool?" And then she says, "Pro tip to keep your ice cream cool, stop burning fossil fuels." So yeah, I think that probably there's a fossil fuel burning generator involved in that process, AOC, but thank you for your input. And this is where we're at. Darwin, take the wheel. Someone made this. I really just like these, whatever they call them, avatars. But someone made this meme on Facebook, and I'm sharing it with you. But there's more, right? Same sentiment. Shh, I've got this, Charles Darwin. So what we're saying is all the people who disagree with the left will die of coronavirus, and thank our God, right? So this is originally, it says Jesus take the wheel, right? Darwin take the wheel is what the leftists have transposed that into. And that's what they're kind of, it's like a prayer, right? Well, this is a prayer. Darwin take the wheel. They're praying to, they're in hell. Here's all the fires, right? And they're praying to Darwin to take the wheel. And Darwin is responding. And the next one, shh, I've got this. What doesn't kill you mutates and tries again. Okay, so we're putting agency into a virus now. It's trying to kill you, okay? And so, and it's the inevitability of it. The idea that this virus is just going to keep getting worse and worse and worse. And I saw several with this same wording, what doesn't kill you mutates and tries again. There's several people making this on the left, okay? It's a very disturbing thought, because what's really happening, if you really understand just the theories here with microbiology, is, you know, as it mutates, if it mutates, it's going to mutate towards a more, towards a less virulent relationship with its host, okay? If any of this is to be, you know, true at all, that is what's going on. Okay, your immune system with the vaccine, Jason Momoa, your immune system without the vaccine. I forgot this guy's name, darn it, but that's mean of this guy. And they white out his eye. Why do they white out his two eyes over here? I don't know, but that's just kind of mean. It started as a virus and mutated into an IQ test. So, okay, I would agree. You know, I think that people who, I disagree with the interpretation of this. This could almost be a meme on the other side, you know, saying if you got the vax, you failed the IQ test. So there's some things where that belies this assumption, you know, that if you put something out there, it's going to be taken the politically correct way, right? But someone else could look at this and say, ah, well, what you're saying is that if you took the jab, if you fell for it, then you failed the IQ test, right? But there's no concept of that in the good old liberal's mind. And then finally, this is just a good old plucking on your heartstrings, right? Some like watercolor here, little boy, and then... With freedom comes responsibility. Your decision to be unvaccinated impacts someone else. President Biden said that. What a great guy. And this is who it impacts. This is who it impacts. This little boy wearing a mask who has to wear a mask, even though no child has ever gotten COVID, let alone died from it. There's no reason children have to wear a mask. But your decision to be unvaccinated is forcing this poor little boy to wear that mask. So feel bad. Feel bad. Just some old-fashioned propaganda from the great minds of the left. But, you know, good work hand-drawing and hand-lettering that. I appreciate that. Those are my memes for today. This is episode 2. Thank you very much for watching. My name is Evan Benton. This is Evdog for Mayor. And the segment is called The Left Can't Meme. Have a great day.